The final days, it obviously was chaotic in a number of ways. I was under the impression, and I know there were several of my colleagues that were under the impression, that how classified documents were being handled was not within proper protocol. Now, with saying that, I think it speaks also just to how reckless and careless much of the administration was.
Cassidy Hutchinson, who served as the aide to Trump's chief of staff, Mark Meadows, alleges in her book enough that Meadows burned documents and handled classified documents in incredibly irresponsible ways. Now, she shed light on this, but before we get to some of the elaboration that she provides in her book, let's go back to the previous reporting just to fill you in case you missed that reporting. So she had claimed in her book that Meadows burned so many documents in his fireplace in the final days of the Trump presidency that his wife complained to Hutchinson about how expensive it had become to dry clean the bonfire aroma from his suits. Now, apparently he didn't just destroyed the documents, according to the book. He made a mad rush just minutes before Joe Biden was supposed to be sworn in to declassify classified documents. Now, the documents were the classified documents, according to what she's alleging, pertain to Crossfire Hurricane, which is the code name for the FBI's investigation into the Russian election interference and the Trump campaign's alleged ties to Russia. In her book, Hutchinson says that the night before the inauguration, at about 10:30 p.m., it became known that Meadows had apparently made copies of those classified documents for multiple conservative politicians and conservative journalists while it was still, again, classified. It had not been declassified yet. Here are the relevant excerpts from her book, Enough. So deputy counsel to Trump, Pat Philbin, asked Cassidy Hutchinson the following. How many copies of that Crossfire Hurricane binder did Mark make? Where are all the copies? How many of them have been distributed? Did Mark already give copies to Molly Hemingway and John Solomon? Now, Molly Hemingway and John Solomon were two conservative journalists who Trump and Meadows were acquainted with. And allegedly, Meadows gave those copies to them. And apparently, Cassidy Hutchinson responded to Philbin's question by saying, quote, yeah, he had a few of his Secret Service agents meet Molly and John in Georgetown earlier tonight while you all were in the Oval Office with the boss, meaning the President of the United States, Donald Trump at the time. Apparently, this is when Pat got nervous, Pat Philbin, because while Hutchinson tried to tell Meadows not to give those copies to anyone, he didn't listen. More binders were supposed to be given to Kevin McCarthy and Mitch McConnell. Meadows allegedly had the House Parliament Select Committee on Intelligence, AKA the House Intelligence Committee, recommend redactions to the documents, but they were still full of classified information, according to Pat Cipollone. And then this is when, you know, Cassidy Hutchinson said she feared a potential national security crisis. The next morning, it only got worse, according to what she's alleging here. So Cassidy Hutchinson says, I was barreling down the staircase when I bumped into one of the Secret Service agents on Mark's detail. He was clutching a Whole Foods brown grocery bag full of loose documents. And that grocery bag full of documents contained what remained of the binders given to the reporters the day before. The Secret Service agent was told they were all there. And remember, these were not declassified documents. These were still, according to her, classified documents. And Hutchinson described what happened after she was given those documents during this conversation with Rachel Maddow. Let's watch.
I dropped the bag on Pat Cipollone's floor. Here are your classified documents back from the reporters, Mark. I didn't hide my contempt, my words rife with sarcasm. Mark and Mr. Cipollone peered into the bag. I saw Mark swallow hard. Pat shot me a piercing look. Overwhelmed, Pat agonized. Seriously, seriously, we do not have time for this. I was already walking out of his office. He then described Mr. Meadows at 11:45 a.m. on Inauguration Day, asking the Secret Service how quickly they can get to the Justice Department because he wants to try to declassify something literally in the last 15 minutes when Donald Trump is president.
Joe Biden's about to get sworn in, so yes.
What was that about? What was he trying to do?
That specific binder was pertinent to Crossfire Hurricane, which, for the record, at the time, I had no idea what Crossfire Hurricane was.
So, look, I don't know if Mark Meadows is cooperating with special counsel Jack Smith. There's been some rumors that he has been, but these are some serious allegations that should be looked into by the special counsel as he continues to prosecute Donald Trump over his handling of classified documents.
So this shows a couple of things. One is their complete indifference to the rule of law. So you can't.
I mean, Meadows was trying to declassify in like the final, you know, hours.
But the Department of Justice had already said, no, we're not going to declassify stuff just because you want to. You have to go through a process, right? And they're like, yeah, but what if I rush it over to you in the last 15 minutes? Okay, and remember, Anna, he did not respect the process because he'd already given it to conservative media figures.
That's a really good point. Right. He was trying to declassify after allegedly giving those binders of classified documents to conservative reporters. Yeah.
And so, look, guys, the guy I talked about yesterday that stuffed the documents into his socks is Sandy Berger. And I'm old enough to remember when Republicans flipped out treating classified documents that way, even removing them from the building. It was just the most unacceptable thing they had ever heard. And which was fair. I agreed. Right? What a weirdo. It's totally unacceptable to do that, and they should prosecute him. But now all of a sudden, you don't even have to put him in your socks. You just take a Whole Foods bag, stuff him in there, give it to your conservative friends all over town, because apparently national secrets are irrelevant. Well, if you think national secrets are irrelevant and you think Donald Trump already declassified everything with his magic laser eyes, then okay, then do you think that the government should share all those secrets that he theoretically declassified? Okay, you got Crossfire Hurricane there. I'm sure you guys would agree to declassify that. But how about all the other things he had? Like how would we invade Iran? That seems pretty relevant. I didn't say it, Trump said it. Trump waved it around, said this is the document that's highly classified that I can't declassify. That shows you our plans for how to invade Iran. Should we declassify that? No, of course not. Then Iran would know and would adjust their defenses. I can't imagine anything more classified. And now Republicans are like, who cares about classified? I don't care. I don't care about national security. Then why'd you pretend our whole lives that you cared about national security?
For political reasons.
So I'm just disgusted.
I think I'm just so done with the hypocrisy and the inability to have any principles or, you know, genuine moral values. Like, we all have a moral foundation, okay? But it seems like that moral foundation in the context of DC, in the context of our political system, gets thrown out the window. And you have all sorts of individuals engaging in bad faith, engaging in hypocrisy, and engaging in behavior that is damaging to our institutions and damaging in regard to the trust that Americans have for our institutions, right? So look, you want to have a conversation about, you know, too much is classified. We need to have a conversation about whether it makes sense to classify as many documents that do get classified in the White House. Great, let's have that conversation. But under the current laws, under what was classified at the time, there is a mountain of evidence showing that Trump mishandled classified documents. According to these allegations, his chief of staff, Mark Meadows, mishandled classified documents. And again, if you don't think that's such a big deal, you can't then turn around and accuse the opposing political party of engaging in bad behavior or criminality if they're caught doing the exact same thing. You get what I'm saying?
Of course, but guys, you also have to be able to do nuance. So let me explain what I mean. Bob Menendez is a crook. And he's a Democratic senator. He's been a crook for years and years and years. And everybody in Washington knows he's a crook. He was tried already. Yeah, he got acquitted on a hung jury. But does that mean he didn't do it? No, it's guilty beyond a reasonable doubt. They couldn't meet that standard. And half the jury believed they even met that standard, right? In fact, most of the jury believed that, right? But what did all the Democrats do? They circled the wagons. That's our crook. We love that crook. He's our beloved colleague. And so now, he gets busted again, stuffing gold bars and cash into his pockets. And it takes most of the Democrats 4 freaking days to figure out that they should say, oh yeah, we're not in favor of the crook. Why? Because they wanted to defend him, because he's their guy. So I'm sick of that partisanship. Now, do you see us doing it? No, I've been telling you Bob Menendez is a crook for now almost decades, right? So But is there a difference between the parties? Yes. Why? Because yeah, it took 4 days and it was maddening. But eventually the Democrats didn't go rally around Menendez and go, no, it's okay. It's okay to get bribes. It's okay to get gold bars and put them in your closet. It's okay to betray national security to the Egyptians. No, at the end, 4 days later, they finally were like, oh, okay, fine. He's a bad guy, mm-hmm. We're not supporting him and he should resign. Republicans, where are you at? With your bad guys? I've never seen you do it, never. Ken Paxton, biggest crook in America. And what do? They rallied.
Well,
No,
Hold on. You have to be fair, Cenk, because it's not the entirety of the Republican Party that stood behind Ken Paxton. The charges and the impeachment proceedings against Ken Paxton were spurred by state level Republicans, right? And,
so if you want to- But you know what though? So in my book, I talk about who's worse, Republican voters or Republican politicians, and it's Republican politicians, and I explain why and et cetera. But in that case, it was the Republican voters that were the problem, because the Republicans in the House in Texas did the right thing. They said, well, we don't want a crook. We want all these different things, but we don't want this guy who's stealing money and bribes and all that stuff, right? And what happened when they went to the Senate to convict? Trump said, no, I like crooks. You have to acquit Ken Paxton. And the voters then converged on the senators and they said, we want the crook. We want the crook. We're Republicans. We love crooks. And what happened? They folded. Anna, that is a goddamn fact and you know it. So, okay, Republican voters, we try to reach out to you and we're principled and we tell you what's wrong with the Democrats. But do you ever do the same? No, you defended Ken Paxton. You defend Donald Trump, who's an obvious crook. Everyone in the country outside of MAGA knows that Donald Trump is a lifelong crook. He's done it 2,000 times over. I love him, he's my cult leader, I love crooks. Be honest for once in your life. You guys are never gonna do it. You're never gonna reciprocate. My whole life, I'm not talking about independents, and I'm not talking about the small sliver of Republicans who from time to time are reasonable. But for the core of MAGA, my whole life, I have never seen you guys be principled, never. Every time, the Democrats, bad. The Republicans, I don't care, steal from my mom. Rick Scott stole from your grandmother. Biggest Medicare fraud in American history. You hate government waste? No, you don't, you love it. Rick Scott is a career criminal and you've elected him 3 times now as senator and governor. So Republican voters, prove me wrong. Show one Republican crook you turn on, no. You'll love the crooks.
Hey, thanks for watching the video. We really appreciate it, guys. And we appreciate it if you become members because that allows us to be independent, honest, progressive, all the things that you don't get from corporate media. And all of that is because of you guys. Hit the join button below and become one of us, become a Young Turk.